Hello and welcome to the Macca's Cup wrap for round three. My name's Zach Milbank and joining me today off the bench is SANFL Talent and Coaching Programs Coordinator Julian Farkas. Julian, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Zach. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming in off the interchange to replace Dicko Phillips just for the 1 week. But before we get into this week's round of matches, just like to have a bit of a chat about you and your background, and perhaps if you could give the viewers a bit of an insight into what you've been up to before joining the SANFL late last year.
I've been involved in footy for many years, professionally, coaching and administrative programs, mainly at junior level. Both here and in Canberra. So I've been in Canberra for 8 years and been back from Canberra. I'm South Australian originally, and have been back for about 8 or 9 years now, and was involved at Port Adelaide Footy Club and South Adelaide most recently.
And the Panthers, obviously coaching the under 16 side, you're able to take them through to the grand final, which hadn't happened too often down there at Noarlunga.
No, it's been some lean years down at Pantherland. So last year we were able to get the boys through to the grand final and play against a very strong Sturt outfit who were far too good. But the Panthers 16s are looking quite good this year, so fingers crossed they go all right.
Now, you're probably too modest to mention that you played league footy for the Panthers as well. And some South Adelaide fans may remember Julian in terms of a trivia question that is the first player to kick a goal on the Noarlunga Oval, now known as Hickenbotham Oval, of course. And what are your memories of that day?
Very large crowd. There was over 10,000 people there. It was a very, very long time ago now, but that's about it. That's about it. Just got the first kick and was able to put it through the goals. I didn't get too many kicks after that, though.
And for the viewers' benefit, your role at the SANFL, what specifically do you do sort of day-to-day and then perhaps on the weekend? Obviously, things will really crank up when the NAB AFL Under-18 National Championships kicks off later in the year.
Yeah, at the moment we're in the planning and preparation stages for all of our state programs. In a few months' time we'll be flat stick when all of those are up and running at the same time, and really looking forward to seeing how our boys go on the national stage in the coming months. Looking forward to it.
Indeed we are. Let's have a look at the games on the weekend, starting off with Glenelg defeating Sturt by 37 points, Jules.
Yeah, it wasn't that way for the whole game. It was a bit of a struggle for the first three quarters, and then in the last quarter, the Tigers were able to kick 7-1 against the Double Blues and pull away for, like you said, a comfortable victory in the end. Brody Trembath was prominent, having 28 touches, and the Tigers, they've got a very strong outfit, especially up forward. And Darcy Fogarty and Corey May, both members of the State Academy program, kicked 3 goals each. Mm-hmm. For the Double Blues, once again, it was Mitch Crowden, who's an under-17. He played state under-16s footy last year. I really like Mitch Crowden. He's a strong body, beautiful left foot, clean hands, makes really good decisions. He had another 26 possessions this week. And another guy who was one of Sturt's better players, who had to stand the guys in the Glenelg forward line, was a guy called Ben Powell, who was combative all day.
Yeah, Mitch Crowden, one to watch from my local footy club, the Meadows Bulldogs. So, lovely left foot kick, as you say, Jules. Keep your eye out on him for the viewers' benefit. Let's have a look at the next game. North defeated South Adelaide quite comfortably by a margin of 80 points.
They did. The Roosters getting a hold of the Panthers there. Jake Walling had 32 possessions and 9 clearances, so he was very busy around the midfield, fed by Jeremiah Scrutton in the ruck. Jeremiah didn't have, he's not a typical ruckman. He's a very athletic, smaller size ruckman, but because he's so athletic, got such a good leap, he can play that position. Brett Kennedy, who's a member of the academy earlier in the year, has come back from a broken hand. He had 29 possessions, which is great to see Brett back and finding a bit of the footy. And up forward, Sam Dye was able to kick 5 goals.
And for the Panthers, not too many to write home about, I guess, in a tough loss.
Tough loss, but Joseph Tillis, who's been a great trier and is a great young man, he was South's best this week.
Let's have a look at the next game. The Eagles defeating Nord by just 1 point, an absolute cracker. And you would expect these two sides, I know it's very early days, but you would think both will be right amongst it when the whips are cracking come September.
Yeah, you would have thought so. Both very, very talented sides and have been quite good throughout the junior programs in the past few years. Mm. A very tight game, as you said, with the Eagles getting over by a goal after the siren, actually. Mm. So very tight. The Eagles had Andy McPherson, who's an academy member, had 24 touches. He's a midfield half-back type. Jackson Lee, who's come back from injury, he missed a fair bit of time during pre-season. He had 20 touches and was handy as well. And Luke Hoare kicked 5 goals for the Eagles.
And for the Red Legs, Jake Pittman was high among the possession winners yet again.
Yeah, he's had a great start to the year, Jake. He's a little ball, a little nugget, a left footer, so you'd like him, Zach. Yeah, found plenty of the footy, but also had 11 tackles to go with his 30 possessions. Yeah. So he doesn't mind putting pressure on the opposition as well. Isaac Hewson, who's certainly one to watch, a very slick mover. He had 27. Another one to watch as well is a guy called Stefan Giro. Okay. Had 22 possessions and kicked a couple of goals as well.
And the final match of the round, we're going to have a look at, Jules. West Adelaide defeating Central District quite comfortably in the end.
Yeah, once again, it wasn't like that the whole day. They were sort of kept in it, West Adelaide, by a guy that we'll talk about in a moment. Yeah. For the Central's Bulldogs, Bradley Heppner had 29 touches, and another one that was a good performer for them was Ryan Falkenberg, who had 10 marks across half back.
And for the Bloods, Jonty Inglis high up there among the best?
Yeah, Jonty found plenty of the footy, having 32 possessions. The one that really caught my eye, and he's this week's Macca's Cup MVP, is a 15-year-old from the
amazing
West Adelaide Football Club. Yeah, it's great to see someone so young performing so well at the next level. Isaac Rankin, turning 16 in a couple of weeks, we're led to believe. Had plenty of the footy, and not only did he have plenty of the footy, but some of the quality was just outstanding to watch. His highlights really are impressive. He was able to kick 5 goals. Mm. Even though he kicked 6 points to go along with his 5 goals, he was still very, very impressive and important in the side's win. His 5 goals all actually came in the first half and effectively kept the West Adelaide Bloods in it in the first half.
And we should make mention 33 disposals and 11 marks to go with his 11 shots on goal as well. So he's had a fair day out, the young fella. And as you say, a great result for him, just 15 years of age, playing against some guys who perhaps even as old as 18. So he's certainly one to keep an eye on, and certainly one to keep an eye on in this week's Macca's Cup highlights, which you'll be able to check out now.
Yeah. Go, Zach. Go, Zach.
Come on, come on.